I said I'd make this video back in October when I made the male version, but you know, it's been a few months and I wasn't able to get around to it until now, so we're doing it now. I'm making the female version of the Pokemon Gengar, and if you don't know what Gengar looks like, I'll put a picture right here. But if you didn't already know, I don't know why you'd click on this video, but moving on. Right now, I'm just setting up the basic pose of what I want for the character. I was going for, like, the male version. I did kind of a rebellious character because Gengar is a dark type, so dark, rebellious, I don't know. I mean, spooky. He's a spooky ghost. So this is just, I went with that idea. And what I wanted to do with this one was originally I was going to do like the tomboy with the backwards hat, but I didn't end up doing that because while I was designing it, it just took on this weird alternative look. I'm not sure how else to describe it, but that's what had happened. And I just was like, okay, that's what it wants to look like, so we're going to go with it. And for the eyes, which I'm drawing right now, I went for this spiky kind of look because Gengar is a very spiky Pokemon. It's got spikes for claws, it's got spikes on its head, its ears. I guess those are ears or horns, whatever they are. It's just a spiky Pokemon, so that's the design I went for. Now, I went for the spiky look because the character is very spiky. Also, the eyebrows are very, you know, angled, angular, whatever you want to call that. Now I'm drawing the outfit, and at first I was gonna go for a short sweater with the high pants. Is that what you call them? High, where they go up to your waist. But then, like, a little bit afterwards, I was like, eh, I don't really like this. So I decided to change it, and somewhere around here is whenever, yeah, I decided to go for a spiky long sweater dress kind of look to go along with the spiky Pokemon. And it's also kind of like the gothy look because I don't know, Gengar is like purple and red, and it just reminds me of gothy. So also with the hair, we went for spiky, but also I tried to give it kind of a feminine spiky look. I don't know. I mean, technically this hair would work on a boy too, but you know, it works for girls too. It's like the androgynous or whatever you call it, where it would work for both. And now I'm just inking it. And for the inking, I just decided to do the where I just ink it with pen and then I go back and clean it up because I was like, eh, I don't really feel like doing the other way, which is like super, you know, not messy and super clean. This also ends up looking pretty clean, but the method isn't that clean, and that's what we're going for. But yeah, I'm just inking it. And I guess we can talk about more experiences with the Pokemon Gengar while I'm inking it because I have no interesting commentary about that part. So, the first time I got a Gengar was in Pokemon. What Pokemon game is that? It's the Kalos region. Which one's that? It's gonna X and Y. X and Y. Pokemon X and Y. And the reason I got a Gengar is because they have the universe. What's that called? The universal trade or whatever, where you can go online and trade Pokemon with everybody. But I had both X and Y, so I was gonna trade with myself. I went through. Because I wanted to get a female Gengar because that's what I wanted. So I searched forever for a female Haunter. Yeah. So I looked in that swampy area. I looked in there for ages trying to find this Pokemon, right? And it took me forever. You could find the male ones, but the female ones, it was just difficult to find them, and I searched forever. I finally got one on both games, and I, you know, got my. I think. Do you need like a stone or something to trade it? I can't remember. But I got everything ready to trade my Pokemon, and I set up for, you know, my character to go on there and put like, this is for my other. The name on the other account to trade with. And when I. It took like maybe 2 minutes. 2 minutes to get there. Maybe at the most. I don't even think it was 2 minutes. It probably was more like maybe 1 minute to get there and get and find my name. And whenever I went there, it was like unavailable. The other person did, my other account didn't show up on my other game. It didn't show up. It wasn't there, and I was just like, what the heck? So I logged back or turned on to my other game because I had X and Y. So I went back to, you know, X or whatever, and I looked, and someone else had traded my Gengar in that one term, because I put I was specifically looking for another Gang or another Haunter to trade, so you know it'd be a both Gengar two way. And someone else traded, and I had lost my Gengar. I'd lost it. I know I went through the Pokemon system that you pay like $3 and you can store the storage system, because it was the other account's Gengar that I was gonna trade. And completely lost. I was like, I searched forever for that Haunter. Now it's gone. But then I looked at it, and I was like, I'm going to trade this Pokemon back. But I looked, and I was like, this Gengar is from Japan. I kind of want to keep it now, because it's, like, from another country. So I still have it. But the point is, I had to go hunting for a female Haunter again, and I was just so irritated. I was so mad, because I had to go do all of that again. And it took just as long to find the other one. And this time, I was like, you know what? I'm going to pick to trade for a Pokemon nobody has, like, you know, Ditto. So I put, I want a Ditto in exchange, because I knew I had a Ditto. So I did that, and nobody traded, because hardly anybody's going to trade a Gengar for a Ditto. So in the end, I did get to exchange my Gengars across to trade, and that's the first time I got Gengar. I don't know if that story makes any sense. It doesn't in real life either. Because all of it was just so I could have a Gengar on both of my games. Because what I did was what I was going to do is trade Gengar for Gengar, and then go to the Pokemon system and trade them back so I didn't have to trade them twice. And that way I would have the original Gengar that I caught, so you don't have to worry about whenever they age so much, or they level up so much, they'll be disobedient. I wouldn't have to worry about that, because it was the original Gengar that I caught. And that was the only reason why I wanted to trade with myself. It's like, I don't want the worry about disobedience, because I always level up my Pokemon to be ridiculous, because I like the training aspect. Like, I swear, that fox you get in X and Y, there's the fox, the frog, and then the green one, whatever that one is. I never got that one, so I don't know. But, yeah, the fox was like, it got Pokerus whenever it was a baby. Because I caught it, my first Pokemon I caught was a Pikachu. And I think the Pikachu had Pokerus, because both my Pikachu and my fox had Pokerus. And I didn't know this until way into the game when I saw that smiley or frowny face, whichever one is. It's a little face. And I was like, what does that mean? And I Googled, and they were like, it means Pokerus. And it, you know, it helps your Pokemon level or whatever it does. And I was like, oh, is that a bad thing? I don't know. And I checked the ultra up my other Pokemon to see who had it. And my Pikachu that I caught right after, you know, I started the game where I only had Pikachu and the fox had Pokerus. And I was like, I caught a Pikachu. My first Pokemon caught Pikachu, and it had Pokerus, and it infected my fox. But it also, you know, is probably the reason why I just swooped the game. Like, I had no trouble with anything at all. Okay, I'm finally done inking. That took forever. Now I'm gonna get the color again. And yeah, I'm just coloring in the exact same color as the other one, because it's Gengar. They're all pretty much colored the same, unless they're shiny. What color are they if they're shiny? I'll have to look that up. I don't remember. But, yeah. Anyway, the Pokerus. So, by the time I got to the Elite Four, my Fox Pokemon was level 100, and I had no issues whatsoever. It was great. I know some people are like, oh, but there's no challenge. And I'm like, I don't care. I play Pokemon because it's fun. I don't play because I want, like, a challenge and to sit there for 50 hours trying to figure out how to beat this person. I just ain't about that. I don't like it. I don't like it. My very first Pokemon game was Sapphire, because my cousin had it and he let me borrow it. Which is why Sapphire is my favorite Pokemon game ever, because it was the first Pokemon game I played. They made the remakes, Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. I love those games. I can pet my Pokemon. I was so happy when I found that out. They were like, here's a Pokemon thing, and you can pet your Pokemon. I was just like, oh, I can pet my... I am, I like, when I was, you know, 10 years old playing Sapphire, I imagined petting my Pokemon and, you know, feeding them cupcakes. I was like, okay, maybe not cupcakes. I imagined feeding them, like, Pokemon food. But I was like, I dreamed of this moment. If only they could follow me around. Like, in Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and Pikachu, they can follow you around. And I love it. I love it so much. It's adorable. But then you get into Pokemon Sword and Shield, and they don't follow. Why don't they follow you? Have I just not figured it out? But I don't think they can follow you. I've tried, and why not? Because, you know, they have the sprites. They created the sprites. They can follow you. All you have to do is program it in. There's already the sprites there. Maybe they'll do an update where they can follow. I hope. I just love having the Pokemon follow me. It's adorable. Because you can see it, like, in Let's Go Eevee. Eevee rides on top of your head, which is adorable. And then the other Pokemon, you can choose which Pokemon they follow behind you. And they can run, and they'll stop, and they'll sit, and it's adorable. I guess I should talk about this picture again. Yeah, I'm doing purple and black because the Pokemon, that's pretty much the colors of the Pokemon. It's purple. Sometimes it's like, you know, because it's a shadow Pokemon, so, you know, black for shadows. And I literally did stripes because I thought they looked cool. And I did the ripped up leggings, pants, whatever you want to call those, because, you know, edgy. That's the only reason, because it's edgy. It's all, you know, rebellious and edgy. Totally. Yeah. And yeah, stripes, because I thought stripes would look cool. And they did, in my opinion, so I kept them. Now I do the skin tone, which I did the exact same as I did the other Gengar, because, you know, Gengar is purple, so the skin's gonna be purple. But yeah, I just made them the color of the actual Pokemon, just different shades, or, yeah, shades, varieties in the color, whatever, tones, whatever you want to call it. I don't know words. Now I'm just finishing up shading and all the fancy effects, cleaning up, all that stuff. So I'm pretty much finished with the whole thing. I will add the female and male versions that I've drawn next to each other so you can see the comparison and all that. And then I'll pop Gengar to see how well you think I did. I don't know. I think I did all right, considering, you know, I tried to stay as close to the Pokemon as possible whenever you're making something humanoid. But you be the judge of that, I guess. If you have any suggestions for other videos, you can put them in the comments below and all that stuff. I don't know if I'll make more Pokemon videos because, I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Depends on what I feel. Because, you know, this one took me months to actually do, so whatever. Leave anything in the comments if you want, even if it's just like, bruh, that doesn't look anything like it. I'd be like, you know, anything. So yeah, that's it for now, and I'll see you when I make my next video, whenever that may be. So, bye.